So with this, we were able to use the tax credits, use the depreciation benefits, use the rebates, take that into the fund, and return, give a customer a lower cost per kilowatt hour than what they're currently paying for electricity. So if you are a homeowner and your electric bill is $200, using our solar lease program, your new electric bill and your lease payments will add up to about $170. So you'll be saving $30 a month with no investment and using clean power. Given the option, you know, most people choose cheaper, cleaner power. And to me, that's the big opportunity. Now the company is just going through this growth spurt and addressing the market. We did, however, hit a stumbling block the beginning of the year. Who of you are familiar with the tax equity market or the solar tax credits? Are all of you familiar with that? Okay, well, so I've got some yes and some no's. Let me just give you the four sources of income when you are financing a solar system. The first is a federal tax credit of 30%. The second is the depreciation value of that asset. The third is the rebate. And then the fourth is the customer payments. Customer payments is actually only 20% of the entire system value. The other 80% is either rebate or federal subsidies. That's essentially the difference. So where I was going with that train of thought. So by adding those subsidies together, we were able to package a solution for a tax equity investor, but there we get a decent return, fairly safe return, by owning solar assets. We'd be managing it for them, and the homeowner would just get a fixed monthly bill, and it'd be a guaranteed result. So if we told the homeowner that unit will produce 10 electrons, and only produced 9, we'd pay them that difference. So we really, really did focus on making sure you take away all the risk factors for the customer. But back to the stumbling block that we hit in the beginning of the year. So in order to value the asset, you as a bank need to have profits to which you can write off the tax credit. You know, how many banks were there making money the end of last year and beginning of this year? So the tax equity market came to a grinding halt. No banks wanted to invest into solar assets as they just couldn't value the tax credits. We were able to close one intermediate fund, a very small one, that kept us going. And then in the stimulus package, there was a small change, and they made the tax credit a cash grant. In essence, it's the same cost to the government. It's just a timing issue when it gets paid out. So that now has opened up the tax equity market again, and banks are starting to get back into the space. This has made it possible for us to grow. Q1 to Q2 was flat. Q3 of this year over Q2 was 3x. Q2, Q4 over Q3 is going to be 4x over Q3. So it's as fast as you can go. We've hired over 120 people in the last 120 days, almost one every day. And this is mainly people on roofs installing solar systems. The market availability is essentially endless. I'm going to grab some water over here. So just a show of hands, how many solar systems do you think have been deployed through all of the US over the last 30 years? I'm gonna give out some numbers and see how many hands give out. 500,000 systems. Any?
Are you going up or going down?
I'm going, do you guys want me to go up or down? this is a fairly educated group, isn't it? Oh, yeah, 100,000 systems, 60,000 systems. That's the answer.
Okay, so so it's just a little under 60,000 systems. This is through all of the US over the last 30 years. You can do that in like the peninsula fairly easily. So it's when I go out raising funding, I often get asked this, the typical VC question. So what's the market opportunity? Have you calculated your TAM? And I think myself, no, we actually went down that route. I'm like, no, it's a waste of time. It's literally a million homes is $50 billion or $30 billion in revenue. So it's, and doing a million homes is not out of the question. It's there are a million homes use power. If you provide them lower cost power, why won't they adopt it? So the addressable market, in my opinion, in the US is, for this group, infinite growth in our lifetimes. As fast as you can grow and as much as you can deploy in our lifetimes is the solar market. As the new housing stock that's been developed, even this down economy, I think it's around 280,000, 300,000 new homes in the US this year. So your deployment of solar systems, even if it doubled or tripled, doesn't even keep up to the new development. So we still have this massive stock that we have to deploy solar systems to. So not only do we have to exceed new development, we have to catch up on the existing stock. So that's going to take a long time. So that's essentially the summary of why we got into it. Our focus is addressing every single barrier to adoption, the biggest one being the upfront cost. Now we've addressed that, is addressing the next barriers and the next barriers. And a small incremental improvement, after 3 years, you step back, you go, wow, we actually did something that's quite nice. But if you shoot out and starting a business, trying to do the big thing, you know, like trying to boil the ocean, you're not going to get anywhere. So just do incremental improvements, you get somewhere. That's the story of SolarCity. Not much more than that. It's a simple business. You install solar systems on people's roofs. Just make sure quality and service is great, and provide them a value proposition that they can't say no to, and the rest will happen. Now it's out to questions.